So last week I gave you guys an update on all of my fish and aquariums. I did so because that was going to be the last time you would see them in that state. You see, I had to make a bunch of changes to my aquariums and some shuffling around of the fish simply because a huge project is on the rise and I'm preparing for it. In today's video, I'm going to talk about some of the things that I've changed as well as what I'm doing to prepare for this big project. Before we begin, I have to mention the following. You guys have been hounding me to get your hands on a do-it-yourself fish keeper shirt for years, so I decided I'm going to do a limited edition 7-day run of this shirt. If you want to get one, you have 7 days, or probably closer to 6 days at this point, to get one. They're very, very affordable. The link will be in the description below. So I guess the first thing we're going to have to talk about is the tank behind me. Inside of it, the African shell dwellers that we had in the official office aquarium that I built along the wall there. You guys remember that 6-foot tank with the bookshelving? These guys are now in a 15-gallon housed on my desk. We're going to unravel the mystery as to why I've done this in the next few minutes, so just follow along with me for now. I decided to take their tank down because that tank is not coming out into the new building at all. In fact, no aquariums will be in my house anymore. Again, the mystery is starting to unravel here. Just because that tank's not coming out doesn't mean they're not going to get a new tank. But you might be wondering, did I move all of the shell dwellers from that 60 gallon to this 15? The simple answer is no. You guys will remember Jeff from One Fish, Two Fish, my local fish store. Well, not technically my local fish store, he's about an hour away. Well, he stopped by the other day and I told him I have some shell dwellers I need to part with. I'd love it if you can come by and, you know, sell them at your store and kind of distribute them locally. And with about 80 to 100 in the tank, I caught up as many as I could. I thought I kept 8, but it looks like it's closer to 12, so I'm probably going to have to give them a few more. So only having a few now doesn't mean that's all I'm going to have forever. These guys will repopulate in no time, and you guys know that. So what did I do with that 60 gallon? Well, for now, the bookcase has just moved out of the room and so is the tank. I'll figure out something to do with them, but they'll most likely go into storage until I need them again sometime.
Now, these guys have always gotten a bit of flake food, sometimes pellets, but because there's used to always be some fry within this aquarium, I tend to stick with flake food because I can kind of crumple it up and make it available for all different sizes. And this is just some NLS foods. I'm typically not a fan of this food, but their flake food tends to be well accepted by a lot of fry, so I use it for those. See, go ahead here, just sprinkle it on top, kind of swish it through there, and let them go at it.
But wait a minute, isn't this the aquarium that the flower horn was in? Yes. Now he's got the planted cube to himself. I figured I don't really have the time or the need to build more aquariums right now. A whole lot more are coming very shortly. It would be pretty much pointless and a waste of money if I did anything for him now, given the fact that everybody's getting new tanks. Much larger tanks. Including a planted tank. You see, I knew that I was going to be upgrading this system as soon as we move out to that new building. In fact, I'm going to go from this 30-gallon cube up to a 120-gallon planted tank. I want to start off from scratch once again so we can go from the beginning up until the end and really bring you along for the development of that aquarium. I didn't want to simply transfer one tank to the other. So, once again, while Jeff was here, I started cutting out all the plants, tossing them into bags for him, and even with the mat, I ripped that out, and when that came out of the water, that was just one massive mat of plants. I had to take it out in 2 sections. Then, of course, drained the tank, cleaned it up, filled it up with some warmer water, and tossed the flower horn in it. He likes the tank, and I think he looks pretty good in it. But I should mention, I am kind of missing the planted tank, and I'm really excited to set up a much larger one in the future.
Feeding this guy is always a blast. I'm going to go ahead and give him a few chunks of fresh shrimp here. Now, when you take a close look at shrimp and
and you wonder why it's pink or maybe it has the red speckles in it, that's the beta carotene in it. And the same thing that turns shrimp red or pink will help turn your fish pink. And a prime example of that would be in flamingos. Did you know flamingos are pink based on the shrimp they eat? If they didn't have shrimp in their diet, they wouldn't be pink, awkward looking birds anymore. So let's go ahead and give this guy some food. Again, with a really good diet and with the proper color enhancers, this guy's gonna look great in time. Gotta be careful with him though, he's quite aggressive. I like to kind of get him ready to eat. Sometimes he'll jump out of the water and get it, but we'll see here. A little bit there. There you go. Give him some more here.
Okay, so with the shell dweller tank shut down, the flower horn put into the planted tank, the shell dweller's put into the 15 gallon that he was in, what's this tank?
Well, that is the stingray tank, that 100 gallon acrylic aquarium I built to house the stingrays in temporarily until they get their new home. Now this is a 100 gallon tank and they will be moved into another aquarium more than 20 times larger. I'll let you guys do the math on that one. To move this tank in here was really simple. Since the office aquarium is gone, this left a large void here. And the purpose was this. I can't get bigger tanks out of here with this tank out where it was. So it had to come in here in order for other tanks to squeeze by. I'll get to that in a minute. In order to get this aquarium in here, I drained the tank down to just a few inches of water, making this just a few hundred pounds. From there, I slowly drug and pushed it into place, making sure that the water's not sloshing around and stressing out the rays. I did it slowly over about 15 or 20 minutes, but draining it and filling it back up really took no time at all. In fact, I just seen it as doing a huge water change. Now the rays get a bit of a chowder here. This is chopped up shrimp and a little bit of scallops within it. This is one of their favorite foods and it's always fun to watch them eat it. Now this is a massive amount of food to feed any fish, especially fish in your aquarium. And if you could only imagine doing this a couple times a day, this produces, what goes in must come out. It's gonna produce a massive amount of ammonia. Plus the fact that freshwater rays already produce an abnormal amount of ammonia due to their biological makeup and their anatomy. We'll talk more about that in the future of, you know, just the real breakdown in my opinions on rays and perhaps even how to keep them. Let me know if you guys want to see that though. Let's go ahead and feed them.
So I like to put it in, sprinkle it throughout, just to make sure they get a whole bunch. And you see, I try to litter the entire aquarium in case one of them is not as an aggressive feeder as another, they still all have a chance to eat. It's always the case where only a couple pieces will fall over there and they'll fight over it until they discover there's a lot more over here if they would just swim around. All the animals are doing good in this tank though. All eating aggressively, all doing really well. Really excited to one day move them into their new home.
So before we move on to the big guy and his little cousin, let's first kind of have a better understanding as to why I did everything that I did here. So the planted tank, it's being upgraded to a 120 and I want to start from scratch. I'm really busy lately with a lot of travel and this new project. So I thought since I'm going to be starting up a new planted aquarium, I really would love to be able to kind of lower my workload inside my office so I could dedicate more time to what's coming. So shutting that down was a decision that was going to happen eventually anyways. The flower horn in the meantime took over that tank, give him a bigger aquarium. We'll figure out something fun for him when the time comes. And then of course the shell dweller's tank got shut down because that tank's simply not coming out there and no more tanks are going to be in the house. The ray tank was moved into position in my office so that we can get this tank out of here at one point. And this is the only tank, just the bare tank itself, is the only tank out of all my aquariums that I'm actually going to keep for the new building. The rest don't really fit into the plan. And you might be thinking, well, that's a lot of big tanks to not bring out there. Well, you don't know what's coming out there. And there's about 1,000 gallons of water in this office right now. But there will be more than 3 times that out in this building. I'm not going to be short on aquariums anytime soon. So when the time comes to be able to move everything, this guy is being moved into the plywood tank. The red arowana is being moved in with the rays, only temporarily, and then I'm going to be able to move this tank outside. And once all the fish are ready to be moved out to the new building, they'll all be moved out at once. This is going to allow me to take my time, move them all properly, and set up their new aquariums properly without having to rush around, tote them around in buckets, or anything like that. So if you haven't put two and two together as of yet, a new fish house is coming. I'd love to give you guys more details on it right now, but it would just be talking like we are now. I want to bring you out there with me so we can both visualize what's coming together. And right now, it's a bare building. The outside is done, the inside will be completed shortly. But once the walls are up, I'll be able to explain where things are going and what's going to be happening. Hopefully I'll be able to do that next week or the week after. Now the big guy is on a bit of a hunger strike. A lot has changed in the office, and I've talked before about, you know, how his territory extends to outside of the his aquarium itself, meaning that he doesn't view just the tank as his. I believe he views a couple feet outside the tank as his as well. From here he's okay, but if we were to come a little bit closer, he's not going to like it too much. So I give him his space, and he takes my space. He's a pretty demanding little fellow, but we all love him. So with all these changes in the office, though, he's put on a little bit of a hunger strike. It's only been a few days, not entirely worried. If your fish does that, though, it's an indication that something is wrong. Perhaps the water temperature has dropped and slowed their metabolism. Perhaps the water quality has dropped. Perhaps the tank is not well aerated. If none of those are the cases, I mean, continue to investigate. My philosophy here is to go at these problems with the process of elimination. Figure out what it isn't, and you'll be left with the answer eventually. Now, to get this guy to eat, though, I just give him time. I don't try to feed him food multiple times a day. I find that that doesn't entice his appetite at all. So what I'll do is I'll offer a few little pieces of his favorite food here, which is scallops. He just loves scallops. Of course, it's the most expensive seafood around here. And this sometimes gets him to eat, and the next day I'll do the same, offering a little bit just until I recharge his appetite and get him eating again. But again, this is something that Asian arowana sometimes do, and even big fish sometimes do, is go on these hunger strikes. So we'll go ahead and offer him a little bit. He doesn't like to eat it as it's falling. He likes to eat it off the floor because he has no manners. So let's go ahead and drop a little bit in here. Tiny little pieces, easy enough to, you know, I usually cut them up a lot bigger for him, but the smaller pieces tend to, you know, accidentally almost get swallowed, so just make sure he gets a little something. So hopefully he'll go at the food. A lot of the times when I leave the room, I'll come back in and it will be all gone. Now feeding this little guy is always a blast. You can see that his gill curl on the far left side there has almost completely corrected itself by increasing the flow in this aquarium. You might notice a little bit of algae on the ground here, on the floor of the tank. That's because I increased the lighting. And a little piles of something over there, that's actually sand I never completely removed yet. I'll have to get to that eventually. This guy's gonna get a bit of chowder. It's shrimp and scallops. He's fun to feed because he's a little pig. He'll eat anything. But the downside is that this tank is built into the wall, so what I've got to do if I want to see him eating is I've got to run through this door, drop the food into the tank, run back around the other side, and watch him eat it. So let's do that together. It's dark in here, so hoping nobody's scared of the dark. Oh, I got the lights on. Okay, let's do this. So just drop a little bit of food back here. One, two, three, let's go. Hopefully we get it in time. And it's falling. Oh, there he goes. Yeah, so they got these little drawbridges for mouths. Always a blast to eat or watch eat. It looks like the food went down in the corner there. I'm not gonna see him pick it up. But he just stuffed an awful lot of food in his mouth. He eats just like I do. He's a good eater. Really good eater. Really proud of him. But like I said, with all of this travel and this new building on the go, I'm entirely exhausted and been having a really difficult time being able to keep up with my day-to-day activities, especially these videos, and I want to apologize up front that if the quality or if anything is lacking as of late, I sincerely apologize. However, that's going to change. Eventually, we're going to move into 3 videos a week and then followed by 5 videos a week of nonstop, absolutely amazing content. I can assure you that I am 100% committed financially, emotionally, physically. Every part of me is committed to what's coming, and it's truly just all for you guys. Nothing but education and inspiration to come out of that building, and no other purpose. Okay, so maybe I'm just being nosy here, but I've got to know, for those of you that are going to go ahead and get this shirt, link will be in the description, what color are you going to get? Will it be black, red, or blue? They are limited edition. I'm calling them a signature series because they do come with my signature printed on one of the letters. I thought that was a nice touch to make them a more limited edition and a more personal feel for you guys. So I hope many of you are as excited about what's to come as I am. I hope that over the coming weeks I can divulge and actually show you and talk to you about what's truly coming and what's going to be happening. But until then, I hope that I'm doing enough to kind of give you an idea, but just stay close with me because I can assure you it's going to be amazing. For those that aren't subscribed to this channel yet, I highly suggest you do because you don't want to miss what's coming. Anyways, I hope that you enjoyed today's video. I'd also like to thank you for watching, but if you join me next week, I will have something new for you.